If you're watching this video, then you want to know the best ways to scan and organize business cards and other kinds of documents. In this four-part video series, I'll be showing you everything that you need for a total scanning system and my best practices for scanning, naming, organizing, and storing scanned items. At the end, I'll tell you how you can download my template for keeping all of your records together so that you can get the most out of scanning and organizing your paperwork. Keep watching. Most business cards are a standard 2 by 3.5 inches, but they can vary greatly in terms of how thick they are, and in some cases, they may even come in unusual shapes and sizes. No matter what kind of business cards you have, the goal of scanning them is to have an organized and easy to recall system. When you want to see a business card in the future, you may only remember a few things about the person or the card. Because of this less than perfect recollection, you need to have a good system in place so that you can find your business cards. To use my system, you'll need a scanner and a computer with enough storage space to hold your scanned documents. If you find that you don't have enough space, you can always purchase an external drive like this one, the Western Digital MyBook, which was named by PC Magazine as this year's best external hard drive. Because it's important to have a dependable backup, it's worth it to get an external drive like this, which is made by a reputable company. You'll also need to know how to install and use software on your computer, which interfaces with your scanner and assists with organizing documents. Because there are so many computer and scanner models available, I'll leave it to you to decide what kind of equipment is best for you. However, if you want recommendations, please see my YouTube channel for different product reviews. At current, some of the best scanners on the market include ones from Fujitsu, Epson, Kodak, Canon, Brother, Raven, and Doxy. As with paperwork and receipts, I recommend scanning business cards on an ongoing basis as you receive them, so that you have a powerful up-to-date system and clutter-free surroundings. If you attend a party or a networking event, you may get many business cards all at once. Otherwise, you'll likely collect business cards here and there over time. As with paperwork and receipts, the best way to scan a business card is to use a document feed scanner using the PDF format. If your scanner or software supports OCR technology, use it to recognize the text and numbers in the card. By being able to search the text inside of the files, this will help when you're looking for cards in the future. When it comes to naming cards, the most important part is the name of the person and the name of the person's company or organization. However, if you can also remember when you got the card, include this in the name of the file. For example, if you know that you received this card in March in 2021, but you don't know the exact date, name it 2021-03-00 Ron Miller Edward Jones.pdf. If you have this card and all you know is that you got it in the year 2018, name it 2018-00-00 Eli Brown Cushman Wakefield.pdf. Depending on the scanner that you use, it may come with an auto-naming function, which will automatically detect the person's name and include it in the file name. When it comes time to organize your digital files, keep them in a folder called Business Cards and use subfolders to further organize them by year. When each new year rolls around, make a new subfolder for the past year and then move the cards from that year into the subfolder. The goal of scanning business cards is to be able to recall them quickly and accurately by searching for keywords. If you're looking for a card but you can't find it by searching, you may need to resort to looking through your cards one by one. If you need to do this, enable a preview panel like this so that you can easily cycle through the cards quickly by pressing the up and down arrows on your keyboard. When it comes to storing your physical business cards, put them in the same document envelope where you put your receipts. For more information on how to store your documents once they're in your document envelope, please see my video on scanning receipts. In addition to scanning business cards, you may also want to scan folding cards like these, which you may have received for birthdays and special occasions. Many of these cards are flat and can be scanned and named using the same process for business cards. However, some cards like these can't be put through a scanner because they're not flat, or they may be covered in glitter or other kinds of loose objects. To scan these kinds of cards, I recommend using a smartphone and a camera stand like this. This is also the process that I recommend for scanning posters and three-dimensional objects. If you can place your items against a plain wall, this is often the easiest way to take a photo of it. For example, this piggy bank is clearly something that I can't scan using a paper feed or flatbed scanner. If I take a picture of it against a clean background and then later crop the image, this is basically the same thing as scanning it. So there you have it. Those are my recommended best practices for scanning and organizing business cards and other items. If you learned something new from this video, then make sure to subscribe to my channel right now. Just click the subscribe button below this video. And now I'd like to turn it over to you. Have I inspired you to scan your business cards as soon as you receive them or keep them in a document envelope? Let me know by leaving a comment below right now. Finally, to download my template for keeping all of your records together in one place, please visit my website, www.seandelman.com. And if you'd like to learn other helpful things from me, please check out my videos on my 7 techniques for reading faster and my 5 rules for how to hire a lawyer and get great results. If you end up purchasing something as a result of watching this video, please be sure to use one of my Amazon links in the video description below. To support my channel on an ongoing basis, please consider changing your Amazon bookmark to one with my affiliate code so that I'll get a small commission whenever you buy anything on Amazon. Please keep in mind that this doesn't cost you anything, and the more support I get, the more I can help people by making new and better content. Thanks again for watching. As always, I'm Sean Delman.